Hi everyone, Dr. Michelle Rodrigues here, dermatologist at Chroma Dermatology. Great to be chatting with you about little lumps and bumps on your skin, what to look out for, and when should you see someone about it. So today we're going to be talking about a few little things that can occur on the skin that are generally benign, but we're going to talk about some really important warning signs of when you might need to see your local doctor or dermatologist. So moles are a common type of benign skin growth on the skin, and they can occur anywhere. They don't necessarily have to just occur on the face. Most commonly, people develop moles early on in their childhood, and then as we get older, we can develop more. Most of the time, moles are created from pigment cells, and that's why they look brown. But they're really important features to determine whether or not you should see someone about your moles. Number one, if you have a really large number of moles, they really should be checked once over by either your local doctor or a dermatologist. But also, other important things to look out for is the A, B, C, D, E rule. So A stands for asymmetry. If a mole is asymmetrical and not quite the right shape, it should get seen to. Number two is B for borders. Borders, if they are irregular, is a warning sign sometimes for skin cancer, so it's important to get that checked. Three is color. If there's multiple colors within a mole, or if the color is changing over time, that is a warning sign to get it checked. D is for diameter. So if the mole is about 6 millimeters or more, then it should probably be checked. And E is for evolution or elevation. So if a mole is growing upwards over time, or if it's growing and changing over time, it too needs to be seen by a dermatologist or your local doctor. Secondly, skin tags. So skin tags are actually just excessive amounts of skin. They can look like a little flap or soft piece of hanging skin, and they most commonly occur in areas of high friction, and they're generally benign. They have no cancerous potential, and I know there are a ton of tips and tricks online about how to get rid of them yourself, but the safest and most effective way of doing this is by seeing your local doctor. There are a couple of ways that this can be done. Number one, and the thing that I like the best, is actually snipping them at the base under a little bit of local anesthetic. It's generally a pretty painless procedure, quick, easy, removes the skin tags and the skin looks beautiful afterwards and it heals up really, really nicely. Another way of treating them, especially if they're smaller, is using a little radio frequency device. So we use a bit of heat the tissue and it falls off over time. I know that a lot of people advocate for something called liquid nitrogen, cryotherapy, or freezing the areas off. And while this can be really great for people that have light skin types, it can cause post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation or brown marks in patients that have skin of color. Milia is definitely not a skin tag. Milia are little cysts that occur in the skin. They can be quite small, generally speaking they are, but we can actually get giant milia, and they can occur anywhere on the body, though they are most common on the face, cheeks in particular, around the eyes, and they can be dealt with pretty easily. Again, we can use a radio frequency treatment that burns them off. If they're larger, we might need to just slit them open with a little blade and pop them out. It's really straightforward. It doesn't even need local anesthetic in most cases, and they are completely benign. They have no cancerous potential. So freckles are little brown spots. They effectively occur more commonly on sun-exposed sites. So they're areas like the face, in particular the nose, as well as the cheeks, but it can occur anywhere, including the arms, the back, and the chest, areas that see sun over a prolonged period of time. And they're basically an accumulation of the cells that make pigment. But it's really important to think about if they are growing or changing in any way, or if you're starting to notice differences, to get it seen to, because occasionally skin things that are a bit more dangerous can pop up in these areas, and it's important to get that checked. But freckles in themselves are totally benign, but they can be removed. If we're wanting to lighten them, it's important to think about a really nice sunscreen, broad spectrum, UVA, UVB blocking. So things like retinols, tretinoin, other forms of vitamin A can also help reduce the appearance of the freckles. I think the other thing to say about freckles is that you can embrace them. Nowadays, I have patients coming in talking about how they're getting freckles tattooed on their faces. People really love them, you know, so I guess the question is, why get rid of them unless they're a cosmetic bother? And if they are, you know, there are definitely options out there, but we can all, you know, embrace the freckles that you have. They're cute. Another thing that can occur really commonly on the skin is warts, and warts can take on many different shapes and forms, but there are some that look quite flat and skin coloured, and these are called plain warts. They can easily be mistaken for moles or for age spots, but all warts are effectively caused by viruses, and so those viruses just live on the skin and can replicate and cause more and more warts as time goes on. Depending on the kind of wart you have, different treatments might be appropriate. We can freeze them with dry ice or liquid nitrogen. We can treat them with a little bit of heat therapy. We can also utilize topical creams, both over the counter and prescribed, to try to assist in bringing these back or removing them completely. One other little spot on the skin that's quite common are little red dots. And often these red dots are seen more commonly in females than males. They're more commonly seen during pregnancy or during breastfeeding. They're little red dots that can occur on the face, on the chest, on the arms, really anywhere, but more commonly in those exposed sites that we've just mentioned. And they are microscopically just a collection of blood vessels under the skin. They're not skin cancer, and they can be removed either with little heat device therapy or with a laser. There are actually so many different things that can cause spots on the skin. It's really hard to get an exhaustive list going here, but I think it's really important to say, if something is new, if something is changing, if something looks different to what it looked like before, if it's painful or bleeding or oozing, or you're just not sure, it's really important to get it checked by a medical professional. Thanks so much, guys, for listening in. If you have any comments or questions, please pop them in the comments below. And if you'd like to check out any more videos of me talking on various things, please look at the links across the side. See you guys. Take care.